Hi everyone, welcome to Bodyworks Prime. Today we're going over the origin, insertion and action, the external oblique muscle. Pictured here we can see an isolated view of just the external oblique by itself. As the fibres approach the midline, they form an aponeurosis, which is a flat tendinous-like material. The aponeurosis then inserts into the linea alba, which is this line which runs down the middle here. Translated from Latin to English, linea alba literally means white line. And the linea alba is made of the three aponeuroses of the muscles which form the rectus sheath. So there's three muscles which form the rectus sheath, and they're the external oblique, the internal oblique, and the transversus abdominis. And if we add another two muscles onto that list, the rectus abdominis and the pyramidalis, then we now have shown here all five main abdominal muscles. So now you can see a lateral view from the left hand side, and you can see I've marked out the origins in red. So that's on the 5th, 6th, 7th, 8th, 9th, 10th, 11th and 12th rib. Moving on to the first point of insertion, you can see a lateral view from the right hand side, and you can see that insertion marked in blue on the iliac crest. So we've got our next point of insertion marked out here in blue again, and that insertion is going to begin on the pubic tubercle here and then work its way across medially onto the pubic crest. And if we go back to a view of that muscle as a whole alongside its aponeurosis, you can see its last insertion point, which is the linea alba, which runs down the middle. And you'll remember that the linea alba is a collection of the three muscles which make up the rectus sheath, which are the external oblique, the internal oblique, and the transversus abdominis. So let's have a look at the actions next. Now the external oblique muscle has two sides. Obviously it's got a right side and a left side. And depending on whether one side contracts or both of them contract together, it's going to influence the action of the muscle. So I'll show you an example right now. Let's say that just the right side here contracts. That's going to result in lateral flexion. Now, in addition to lateral flexion, a contraction of one side can also contribute to lateral rotation as well. But what happens if both sides contract together? Now, contraction of both sides is going to flex the abdomen forward like that. So we've got flexion as the action when both sides contract together. In addition to this, both sides obviously connect onto the ribs here as well. So as they can contract, they can pull on the ribs, and that pulling on the ribs can also assist in forced expiration as well. So pushing breath out of the lungs essentially. So if you've enjoyed the video or you find it helpful, you know which buttons to press. Press those buttons down there because it really helps out the channel. Thank you very much for watching everyone. See you all next time.